Welcome back to TechKid FX for another Phantom price prediction update. And in this video, I'll be giving you the latest developments that have been happening here on the Phantom chart, which at the time of this recording has lost the 20-day MA here on the 4-hour chart. We have also managed to get into our minimum retestment area in the formation of this higher 80 wave count 2, and that is this yellow target area that I have here on the charts. And that means we have done the minimum that I was expecting this second wave to the lower side to do, and there are chances that very soon we are going to see the reversal to the upper side and continue gearing up in the formation of these higher 80 wave count 3. And before I get further into the technical analysis and also give you the short-term scenarios that I'm expecting to play out over here, first give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and also check out the channel membership, and allow me to continue with the video here on the 4-hour chart by first giving you a quick recap of what has been happening, where you can see that after making our lower low at around the $0.16 mark, we started this massive bounce to the upside, obeying the 80 wave structures, where you can see that I have this 80 wave structure in red, having that as the first wave, then a wave 2, a wave 3, giving us a peak at around the $0.3575 mark. Then we saw a corrective structure in the formation of that wave 4, before we continued gearing up in the formation of this wave 5, giving us a peak at around the $0.657 mark. And after seeing the formation of these 5 wave structure to the upper side in red, we completed an even larger 80 wave count 1 to the upside of this 80 wave structure right here in yellow. And after seeing the formation of a larger 80 wave count 1, whatever I was expecting here on the short term scenarios was a corrective structure in the formation of that larger 80 wave count 2. And using the Fibonacci's, connecting them from the low of the first wave down there to the high of that wave 1, that gave me a minimum retestment area in the formation of that larger 80 wave count 2 between the Fib level 0.5 and the Fib level 0.618, which is a target area that lies between the $0.4105 mark and the $0.3526 mark. And it is within this yellow target area down here that I was expecting to see the low for that larger 80 wave count 2. And you can see that here on the charts, we have managed to get into that minimum retestment area, giving us a low at around the $0.3894 mark. And there are chances that Phantom might have bottomed in the formation of this wave 2, and soon we are going to see the reversal to the upper side, see a break above the 20-day MA, have the support that we need to get to our next key area of resistance at around the $0.5 mark, manage to break above it, see a retest, continue gearing up, and also see a break above the wave 1 high at around the $0.657 mark. And the moment we manage to break above the higher 80 wave count 1 high, then that would be enough confirmation that whatever we are seeing over here is the start of an explosive move to the upper side in the formation of these higher 80 wave count 3. And assuming that we have seen the low for that higher 80 wave count 2, since we have managed to get into the minimum retestment area, we can be able to sketch out a minimum target area to the upper side in the formation of that larger 80 wave count 3 by connecting the trend based Fibonacci from the low of the first wave to the high of that wave 1, then drag the Fibs to the low of the second wave, and that gives me a minimum target area to the upper side in the formation of that wave 3 at the Fib level 1.618, and that is at around the $1.1796 mark, and that is the minimum that I will expect Phantom to do in the formation of that wave 3, and also expect a 5 wave structure in formation because of the impulsive nature in the formation of that larger 80 wave count 3. But as long as we are holding below the 20-day MA here on the 4-hour chart, we need to be prepared for a move that could possibly give us one more leg down within this yellow target area, so that we can fully maximize the target area in the formation of that wave 2. That is still another possibility that we need to have in mind. There's still the risk of making one more leg down in the formation of these higher 80 wave count 2. And in case that happens and we continue holding between the Fib level 0.5 and the Fib level 0.618, then there are chances that soon we are going to see the low for that second wave and start gearing up in the formation of that larger 80 wave count 3. So that is the other case scenario that we can expect on the worst case scenario in case the breakdown continues. And in case we see a break about out of this target area that we have over here, then once that move plays out, I'll be able to give you areas on the Fibonacci's that we also need to continue holding within for us to still say that whatever we are seeing over here is the formation of that larger 80 wave count 2. And that is what I'm expecting here on the short-term scenarios. And before I give you the long-term scenarios that I'm expecting to play out, we can first take a look at the indicators, where here on the 4-hour chart, You can see that on the RSI we are trading at around the 38 mark, meaning we have massive room for us to fully support higher prices in case the reversal to the upper side in the formation of that larger ADT wave count 3 starts. But in case the breakdown continues, that move on the RSI will still be supported. Also, taking a look at the MACD, we have been able to print a bearish cross, but we are seeing a bit of a decrease in the selling momentum, meaning there are chances of starting that reversal to the upper side and jumping to the daily chart for further analysis, and also give you the long-term scenarios that I'm expecting to play out, basing it on the ADT wave structures. Here on the daily chart, you can see that from these low prices that we had been trading within, we saw that massive bounce to the upside, seeing the all-time high at around the $3.5 mark in what I'm terming as that first wave to the upside. And after seeing the all-time high, we started the bear market, where we had been seeing lower prices in this ABC corrective structure in a move that gave us a low at around the $0.16 mark in what I'm terming as the bear market low in the formation of that larger ADT wave count 2. And on the long-term scenarios, after seeing the formation of that larger ADT wave count 2, whatever we expect next is the start of an explosive move to the upside in the formation of this wave 3, where I have minimum target areas at the Fib level 1.618, and that is at around the $5.7395 mark, and that is the minimum that I'm expecting Phantom to do on the long-term scenarios in the formation of that higher ADT wave count 3. So that is what I'm expecting here on the short-term scenarios and also on the long-term scenarios, and let's be patient and see how that plays out, and I'll be keeping you updated.